Hi, it's Emma. Your qualifying goals came up in the board meeting this morning. Here's what to expect.
It's time for today's qualifying session to begin here in the United States. Welcome to the Circuit of the Americas. This is the kind of track that eats rear tyres for breakfast, or so I'm told by more experienced drivers than myself.
Well, tyre management is key here, specifically the rears. It's all too easy to overheat and wear the rear tyres if they're punished out of the low-speed corners. Most teams won't be able to avoid some kind of issue here, especially the teams that are running less downforce.
Is all set then for the race tomorrow. But before we go, let's quickly remind ourselves of our top three, who are Hamilton, Areno, and Valtteri Bottas. With qualifying complete, all that remains is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us then.
Guess who? I've seen the team's expectations for the race, so I thought I'd pass them on and wish you luck. Take care.
In 2012, America's on-again, off-again love affair with Formula One finally seemed to settle down with the completion of this wonderful racing facility here in Texas. Since then, we've been treated to some incredible races, including, of course, that classic wet-dry championship decider of 2015. We're racing today then in Travis County, Texas, where 20 corners and speeds of up to 200 miles an hour await us on this magnificent racetrack. It's 60% full throttle with plenty of good opportunities to pass, especially through the two DRS zones into turn 1 and at the end of the long back straight into turn 12. What a race we have in store today. I'm joined again today by none other than Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, obviously there's a lot of development work that goes on with these cars between the races. You've been both a test driver and a race driver. What differences are there in the way you approach those roles?
Interesting question, Crofty. They're two very different mindsets. I mean, when I tested for BAR, we had full in-season testing where, per driver, you'd cover up to 15,000 kilometres per season. And in that role, it was more about working for the team, trying to help them improve the car and drive as systematically as you could, so that that data could be analysed in the most consistent way. When you're lining up on the grid for a race, however, your frame of mind's all about what you can get out of the situation on that day, and the car's the tool to help you achieve what you want. You still want to focus on the setup, of course, but it's more about the here and now, getting yourself as far up the field as possible, and less about development work for the future.
Okay, you can break late into one because of the incline. It's a slow corner though, so make sure you stay out of trouble. Good luck.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position and a Renault alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Ricciardo, Max Verstappen, and Vettel, Massa, Alonso, Gutierrez, and Sergio Perez, Grosjean, Rosberg, Jenson Button, and Magnussen, Kvyat, Hülkenberg, Kimi Raikkonen, and Rio Harianto, Sainz, and Ericsson, Pascal Wehrlein, and Felipe Nasser starts from the back of the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. win then for the Renault team today. Tell me, what was the key to this success?
The difference was clearly in the strategy. You could tell they'd done a lot of work on the pit wall to really optimise each stint and get the most out of the tyres. And it highlights just how much of a team sport this really is. But credit to the driver as well though, there's no good having a well-oiled machine behind the scenes without a talented hand on the wheel, of course.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. Well, the gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race today for our championship leader. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Well, I have to give it to Lewis Hamilton. You know, it was just the kind of drive you'd expect from a multiple world champion.
It may already be wrapped up, but let's look at the constructors' standings. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. There was also a strong showing from the McLaren team today as they make their way up the standings. There'll be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you can join us at the next race to see just who will come out on top.